Hello everyone, welcome to Engineering Made Easy. So this is the 14th video session of Digital Circuits and Logic Design. In this video we will know about autonomous clock concept and also input independency. So this is the problem that we will solve today, and by the end of the solution of this problem we will see why it is called as autonomous clock or input independency. So we will start solving this problem. So these are the present states and these are the next states when x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1, that is the input, and z is the output. Now the first step is to assign the value, that is the binary value. Here we have 6 states, as you can see, that is A to F. If there were only 4 states, we would have used only 2 bits to represent. But here we have more than 4 states, so we have to use 3 bits to represent. Let us represent A as 0, 0, 0. And let us represent B as 001, that is the binary value for 1, and C as 010, that is binary value of 2, and so on, as you can see here. Okay, so these are the bits or binary value that will represent the states. Now we have to draw a similar table as this, but instead of writing A, B, C and etc, we have to write the binary values. Okay, wherever we have A here, here, we have to write 0, 0, 0, and we have to represent the MSB as Y1, okay, and LSB as Y3. You can give any name instead of Y1 and Y3. Okay, so we will draw the table now. So we have completed the table now. Wherever we have A, we have written the binary value, that is 000. See here we had D. In place of D, we have to write 011, which is the value assigned to D. So this is how we need to complete the table. And for Z, we have to write the output as it is, because they are already present in binary. Now, as I said, we have to name the, I will name MSB as Y1, okay, and going through, I will name LSB as Y3. Now, using KMAP, we have to calculate the expression for Y1, Y2, Y3 and Z, okay. So, first we will calculate Y1. Here we have 4 inputs, that is x, y1, y2 and y3. So we will have a KMAP with 16 blocks, that is 2 raised to 4. And to calculate y1, we have to consider the first column in this, that is these MSBs. Okay, as you can see, we have to consider these values. Okay. And to calculate Y2, we have to consider the second values, that is the second column. And to calculate Y3, we have to consider the LSBs, okay. Because we have assigned Y3 to the LSB, so we have to consider only the LSBs to calculate Y3. So first we will calculate Y1. See here, X, Y1, Y2, Y3, all are 0. Okay, here we can see 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so if x is equal to 0, we have to consider this column. And see where y1, y2, y3 are 0. Here we have y1, y2, y3 are 0. So the value will be 0. Okay, now see here, x is equal to 0, y1, y2, y3 is equal to 0, 0, 1. Okay, x is equal to 0, that means this column, okay, y1, y2, y3 is 0, 0, 1. So the value is 0. Okay, like this we have to go on filling the KMAP. See here, I'll just take x is equal to 1 now. Okay, I'll just show one value. I'll just show this value. X, y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 1, 0, 1. If x is equal to 1, we have to consider this column. Okay, and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 0, 1. Okay, see here, what is the value? It is 0. Okay, I'll just take another random value. I'll just check for this value. X is equal to 1 and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 0, 1, 1. If x is equal to 1, we have to consider this column and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 0, 1, 1. Okay, so the value is 1 here. Just write down 1. Like this, complete the table. Okay, I have completed the table for the values given, but I have left these as blank because see here, when x is equal to 0 and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 1, 1, we don't have any value because y1, y2, y3 are never 1, 1, 1. They don't have that value. Okay, so what we can do, we can fill it with a don't care. Okay, wherever the values are not present, just fill it with the don't care. Okay, now we have completed the K-map. So follow the K-map rules and group the ones now. Okay, here we have a group. Don't care can be included with one because they can take 0 or 1 value. See, don't care values are not necessarily to be grouped with ones. It is not compulsory. But if you can form a larger group or a bigger group, then you can use the don't care values to group. Okay. See now, here we have calculated the value of y1. Y1 will be equal to, check the value, here we have y2. Okay. So y1 will be equal to y2. Okay, now we will calculate y2. We have to follow the same procedure as we have followed to calculate for y1, but instead of considering the MSBs, we have to consider the second bit or the middle bit that is present, which we have assigned for y2 here. See here, I'll just take one random value. I'll just calculate this value. Okay, when x is equal to 0 and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 0, 1. When x is equal to 0, we have to consider this column because x is equal to 0 here, and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 0, 1. Okay, here we have 1, 0, 1. So what is the second bit? It is 0. Write down the value. Okay, now for x is equal to, I'll just calculate this value, x is equal to 1, y1, y2, y3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. X is equal to 1, we have to consider this column, and y1, y2, y3 is equal to 0, 0, 0. What is the second bit we have? We have 1. Okay, write down the value. So I'll check this value. Okay, x is equal to 1, y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 1, 1. X is equal to 1, this column, and check if we have value for y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 1, 1. We don't have value here. Okay, so just write down a don't care. Okay, like this, complete the K map. Okay, I have completed the K map now. Now we have to group the ones. See here. Here we have a group. Okay, group of ones. Here we don't have to make another group for don't care because they can take a value 0 or 1. So in this case, let us consider them as 0 so that we don't have to group them. Okay, so from this group, we will have the value of y2 is equal to y1 bar y2 bar. Okay, this is how we need to calculate, and similarly we will calculate for y3. Okay, this is the k map for y3. So now we have to consider the LSB, that is the last bit to calculate the y3. See here, I'll just check some random values. Okay, 0 0 1 1. So when x is equal to 0, consider this column, and y1 y2 y3 is equal to 0 1 1. Okay, here we have value. What is the LSB? LSB is 1. Okay, write down the value. I'll just check for this value. Okay, x is equal to 0, y1 y2 y3 is equal to 1 1 0. X is equal to 0, this column. Okay, y1 y2 y3 1 1 0. See here, 1 1 0 is not present, so we have to write don't care. Okay, I just check for this value. When x is equal to 1, this column. Okay, y1 y2 y3 is equal to 1 0 1. Here we have 1 0 1. What is the value of LSB here? It is 1. Okay, like this we have to complete the table. So I have completed the K map. Now we will group the ones. Okay, see here, here we have one group. Okay, we will consider don't care as one here, and here just take another sketch. Okay, here we have another group. Okay, and here we have one more group. Okay, and here we have another dual group. Okay, so four groups are represent here. This don't care we will consider it as zero, because it cannot be included with any other group which has one. So from this group we will get x bar, y2 bar, y3 bar. Okay, from this group we will get y2, y3. Okay, and from this group we will get x, y3. From this group we will get x, y2. Okay, so just add them and we will get the expression for y3. X bar, y2 bar, y3 bar, plus y2, y3, plus x, y2, plus x, y3. So this is the expression for y3. Now we have to calculate the expression for z. We have to follow the same procedures, but instead of considering these columns, we have to consider these two columns. Okay, because we are calculating the expression for z. Okay, here we have z. See here, I just calculate some random values. I'll calculate this value. When x is equal to 0, y1, y2, y3 is equal to 0, 1, 1. X is equal to 0 means this column. Okay, here we have x is equal to 0. And when values are 0, 1, 1. Okay, 0, 1, 1 we have here. Okay, so the value will be 0. Now I'll just consider another value. Okay, when x is equal to 1, y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 0, 1. If x is equal to 1, we have to consider this column. Okay, when y1, y2, y3 is equal to 1, 0, 1, we have 0 as value. Okay, now I'll consider this value. When x is equal to 1 and y1 y2 y3 is equal to 1 1 0. X is equal to 1 means this column. Y1 y2 y3 is equal to 1 1 0. Check if we have that value. Okay, we don't have that value, so just write down a don't care term. So like this, complete the K map. Okay, I have completed the K map. Now I will group the ones. Okay, here I have one group. Okay, so z will be equal to x y 3 bar. Okay, now we have got the expression for all the inputs, that is y1, y2, y3 and z. Now we will draw the logic circuit. Okay, so these were the expressions, and see here y1 and y2, expressions for y1 and y2. y1 depends upon y2 and y2 depends upon y1 and itself, that is y2. So first we will draw the circuit for y1 and y2 so that it will be easy for us. So first write down y1 and y2. Okay, check here, y1 is nothing but y2, that is the feedback from y2, that is the output of y2. We have given it to y1. Okay, so it will generate the output y1, and see here, what is y2? y2 is nothing but y1 bar multiplied with y2 bar. Okay, so we will take output y1 here. Okay, and we will add a bubble so that it will be y1 bar, and we will take another feedback from y2. Okay, we will add a bubble so that it will be y2 bar. Now we will add them together and we will give it to y2 so that we can generate y2 here. Check here, y2 is equal to y1 bar multiplied with y2 bar, and y1 is equal to y2. So this circuit, okay, this circuit is called as autonomous clock. Okay, because see here, both y1 and y2 are not dependent on any input. Okay, they are not dependent on x, so it is called as input independent circuit or autonomous clock circuit. So now we will draw the circuit for y3 and z. So now we will draw the circuit for y3. So write down y3 first. Okay, y3 block first. So what is y3? This is the expression. So here we have y2 in the expression. We will take one line, okay, that is the y2 line. See here, x bar multiplied with y2 bar multiplied with y3 bar is the first term. Here I will take the x input. So x, it is x bar, so I'll just add a bubble. From here I will take the y2 bar. Okay, from here I will take y3 bar. I will add it and I will have a first term. So the second term is y2 multiplied with y3. So I'll just take y2 from here. Okay, and this is the y3. Okay, so this is the second term, and the third term is x multiplied with y2. I'll take x input from here and y2 input from here. I'll add them together, so I'll have the third term, and the last term is x multiplied with y3. So I'll take x from here and y3 from here. I'll draw an AND gate, and I have to OR all the terms together to get y3. So just add one OR gate, okay, and give the output. So this here, sorry, here I will have y3 as output. See here, y3 depends upon x, so it cannot be called as the input independent circuit. So the last is Z. Okay, we are only left with Z now. So the expression is Y1 bar multiplied with Y2 bar. The expression for Z was X multiplied with Y3 bar. Okay, so I'll take X from here and Y3 bar from here. Okay, here we have X multiplied with Y3 bar. So I'll just add a bubble to Y3 and I'll add them together. Here I will be having Z output. So this is how we can draw a logic circuit using autonomous clock and the input independence concept. Okay, if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below, and also please like the video and also subscribe to my channel, and also please share with your friends. Thank you.